Hi there guys, this is Nikhil from GreedyTech and these are the best apps of this episode. So this is going to be a weekly series. Do check out previous and next upcoming videos to know about the latest apps that you should definitely check out. As this is the first episode, there are some apps, or most of the apps are pretty old but they're well established. First we have the Solid Explorer. I personally prefer ES File Explorer, but due to the latest updates and bloatware on ES Explorer, I am using Solid Explorer as an alternative. It has material design with two tabs, we have themes and the option to change primary and accent colors. Basically a lot of customization to personalize it according to your preference. It has almost the same features that you can find in ES File Explorer, just in different places. And some features can be added by downloading plugins. You just need to give its UI some time for it to grow on you. It is definitely a great improvement over your stock file manager. Next we have Appdialer. This is by far the best and the fastest way to find apps and switch between them. I have literally stopped using AppDrawer for years now. You can use the number pad to search for apps or use the QWERTY pad. If you get the pro version, you can long press the app icons and get additional options to uninstall, pin to home screen, open the app info page, or open the app in Play Store. Basically saves a lot of time if you are a productivity freak like me. I am personally addicted to this app and this is the app I install on all the phones I have and even on my friend's phone. So with all that said, I've literally skipped on how it works. So basically you get the number pad or the QWERTY keypad. You can simply search for the app name and it will show you up in this area. So for Play Store, you can say PL and you'll get a shortcut for Play Store or any other app like that. Just take my word for it, give it a try and you'll definitely be addicted to it. Next we have Dozer. If you have an old device running Lollipop or KitKat and want the Doze feature from Android Marshmallow, you can give it a try. In all my testing, I felt it was working. So basically, it's an app to improve your battery life by reducing the number of notifications you get when your device is sleeping. Next we have Simple Note. As the name suggests, it's a simple note-taking app. It's literally simple, plain like a notepad. We can change the font, theme, we can even add a pin for security, and the best thing, it has apps for all the platforms along with Cloud Sync. Before Pushbullet was released, I used this to share information between computers, like links and stuff. Next we have Brave Browser. Earlier it was called Link Bubble. It's a floating browser. I paid for it when it was first released, but now it's for free. It saves you a lot of time if you browse on your phone a lot. It opens web pages in floating bubbles, just like the Facebook chat head, and you can throw the bubble left, right, or bottom to perform various actions. Just give it a try and you'll simply love it. If you have a low performance phone, it might slow it down if you try to open a lot of bubbles at the same time. So just limit it to 2 or 3 bubbles at a time. And if you just keep it open, it'll definitely drain your battery, so use it cautiously. Next we have Daygram. It's more like a note-taking app, but it's a very cool diary. You can change fonts, themes, even set a pin for privacy. You can backup and restore your data from Dropbox. On the whole, just a cool-looking diary. Next we have Authy. It's an alternative for the Google Authenticator. If you use two-step authentication, you can use this app to generate the code specific to your account. You can protect the app with a pin, you can protect your accounts itself by a backup password. It syncs your account with your phone number and uses a secondary password for authentication. So in terms of security for the app, it's pretty solid and the functionality is pretty good too. Next we have Follow Shows. If you watch TV series and want to be notified when the next episode is going to air, or if you just want all your favorite TV shows on a calendar, this app can do that for you. It also gives you the latest information about all your favorite shows. Next app in the list is Lemma. Now it's a very old app, but it still works flawlessly. It can perform actions based on locations. It doesn't use your GPS, so it won't consume a lot of battery. I use it to turn off Wi-Fi when I leave my home and turn off mobile data when I arrive home. So you can do some location-based automation like that. And if you want to control your phone or if you want to optimize your phone for better battery life, you definitely need to try this app. Next we have Wallpapers from Google. This is the wallpaper app that you can find in Pixel phones, but fortunately they haven't limited this app only to the Pixel phones. We can install it on any phone and use the Google suggested wallpapers. There aren't many as other wallpaper apps, but these are something that Google picked out themselves. So a pretty good app for high quality wallpapers. So that's pretty much it for this list guys, let me know what kind of apps you want to see, something interesting or productivity related stuff or whatever. If you have any recommendations or your favorite apps, do let me know by commenting below this video, and stay tuned for the upcoming episodes. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel already, do subscribe and stay tuned to us. This is Nikhil from GreedyTech signing off. Have a nice day.